Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel, and today you're going to learn how to use Git the easiest way. Alright, let's get started. Before we get started on Git, I want you to learn a few things about Git. And we've our community, a couple of guys have been asking that what is the difference between Git and GitHub. Alright, so I'm going to explain that in a few minutes or a few seconds in this video, and so they have a clear understanding of what Git is and what GitHub is. Alright, okay, so before we get started, let's understand what Git is. If you go over to this URL here, I'm going to put it in the description of this video so you can learn exactly what Git is. Okay, basically Git is a version control system, allows you to record changes in your files, and when you share versions, it means that you can go to a previous versions of your code, you can have a place to store your files, and you'll be able to track changes in your code base, right? It's a way for you to manage your code, essentially. All right, I want you to go over to this URL and learn everything about the Git. So you just read over this article and you're good to go. All right, so how about what GitHub is? GitHub is a community where you can upload your files. It uses the technology of Git, and you can push your codes to the community, and you can other people can access your code. You can use this to work as a team, and people get your code download and they make changes on their own side, and they push. Also, it basically is a social coding community, something like that. Alright, so there are other examples of repositories that use Git technology. You have GitLab, Bitbucket, and also you have the Azure DevOps. It uses Git also for its own version control. Alright, so now let's go to the tutorial where I'm going to show you how to use Git the easiest way. Alright, so the first thing you want to do is to go download Git at git-scm.com, and when you download, you download for the version of your computer you're using. I'm guessing this automatically detects that I'm using a Windows, so it shows that I should download Windows version 2.2n for my Windows. Alright, once I get this downloaded, I'm going to install. I've already installed it on this system, so I'm not going to download that. Alright, it's pretty straightforward to install. So once you download it, you just double click on the file and it's going to install on your computer. Alright, another thing you need is the GitHub desktop. I love this. It works with my Azure DevOps, and also it works for GitHub. I've not tried it with other stuff like GitLab or Bitbucket, but I'm pretty sure it's probably going to work. Alright. Now once you have this page, desktop.github.com, you just click on the download button and you download the version that matches your margin. Alright, so as a newbie, you want to know how to push, you want to know how to do a pull request, you want to know the basic commands that you need for your project and by using Git. Alright, so this is exactly why this tutorial is there. Alright, I have my GitHub account at github.com/Tyomi, and I'm going to show you how I've created be able to push this repositories this project over to my GitHub account. I have some private repos, and let's see how it is done. All right, so let's say you have a project, and I have a project here called GS Drum Kit, and I want to push this project over to my GitHub repository. I have the project here. All right, I'm building a simple GS Drum Kit. Now, what I'm going to do to be able to push this is let me open this in a code editor. And I use Visual Studio Code, so that should be easy for you. All right. Okay, so this is my code, and I recommend that you go over to the terminal and you create a new terminal. I use the terminal for some Git commands that you need. All right, if you go over, if you check the bottom left of the screen, you will see that you will not see anything related to this Git repositories, because this project has not been Git has not been added to this particular file, so particular project. So let's solve that. All right, so you have an existing project and you launch your GitHub desktop. Launch a GitHub desktop. You wait a while, it's going to open. Okay, so I have GitHub desktop. If you see on my GitHub desktop, I have a file, I have a project, and it's showing me that there's a commit I need to push to the origin, so I'll push that to origin. I'll explain all this later, so you understand how it works. All right, so one thing you want to do is to click on this drop down and click on add. All right, so what I do is I click on add existing repository. If you're not logged in on the GitHub desktop, it's going to tell you to log in with your GitHub account credentials. So you just log in with your GitHub account credentials. All right, so it's going to tell you to choose local path. I'm going to choose the local path for my project, and this is GS Drum Kit. I'm going to navigate to the root of the project and click on select folder. Now it's going to tell me that this directory does not appear to be a Git repository. Would you like to create a repository here instead? All right, so I'm going to click on create a repository, and I'm going to give it a name, and you can give it a description for your project: a GS Drum Kit developed in JavaScript. All right, you can initialize this repository with a README. It's going to add a readme.md to this repo, so you may take this button, you may not. Alright, so I'm going to click on create repository. You give it a while, it's going to create a repository for this project. And now we have added Git to our project. And you can see the current repo is GS Drum Kit. It's showing me that I should push this repository to my GitHub account. Now let's go back to my GS Drum Kit, and if you go over here, you see something like master. So it's telling me that I have added a repository, Git repository, to my code. And it added a couple of files. So the readme.md file that I told it to add, and also it has a .git attributes file to my repo. Alright, so if you want to push this repo to your GitHub account, all you need to do is to, there are two ways to do it. You can do that from your code, or you can do that from GitHub Desktop. But I recommend using GitHub Desktop. Alright, so once you click on publish repo, it's going to show public repository, and it's going to ask you if you want to keep this code private. If you keep this code private, it's going to see something like, people are not going to see this repository in your profile, only you can see that, and it's going to come with a private label. Alright, and if you want other people to see this repository, you have to uncheck this. And once you uncheck that, you just click on publish repository, and you're going to wait a while, and it's going to publish the branch, and your master is going to publish it to your GitHub account. Alright, boom, now we are good to go. Now let's check our GitHub account and refresh our repository tab. Alright, so I have GS drum crates 16 seconds ago. Alright, now let's go. Now that is our code. Now let's say that you make a new, I always recommend that once you want to add a new feature or you want to fix something in your code, you always make a new branch. A new branch tells your code that I want to move everything on my master branch. I want to move it to another branch. I don't want to touch the code here. I want to move it to another branch. Okay, so you can, I use a couple of commands for this. And what I do is use the git. On my terminal, I do git checkout, my dash b. And if you want to add a new feature to your code, you can use the feature you can start it with feature, and then you put a slash, so it's going to create a folder, kind of a folder, and it's going to put any branch name under that folder. So I'd like to make sure my code is formatted that way, so that when I go and see the overview of all my branches, I like to go under the feature branch or go under the fix or bug branch. Alright, so let's say I want to add let me just call it a simple branch, add sounds. Alright, once I hit on the enter, it's going to create that branch for me. Also, alternatively, you can click on the master here. It's going to show a little drop down. Do you want to create a new branch? Create a new branch, and it's going to work. Alternatively, you can use the code here. Once you hit that, it's going to say switch to a new branch feature / add sounds. All right. Now that we have added a sound, okay, let me add a change to this code. And I just make a little edit. And I do, here is a little comment. Okay, so I added a little comment to this code. When I save it, it's going to show here that I need to commit this. I need to write a comment for this code. So what it means that is that I have to commit this code to this branch. If you don't do that, this branch will not see this change. That's why there's a little star here that is showing that you have to commit this code. Alright, so added, you write a comment here, added a description of exactly what you did on your code, added a little comment. Alright, so and this will automatically be committed to this branch. Alright, so if you want to push this branch to your remote, if you go to your GitHub desktop, you see that it has switched to a new branch. You see your current branch is feature slash sounds. You can do all this also in your Git desktop. In case you want to create a new branch, you can create a new branch here. You can also publish the branch, alright? Or you can publish the branch by clicking on this. So once you publish the branch, it's rolling. Okay, we have published the branch. You're going to see it on your online repository. So let's go in the JS drum kits, and you can see feature slash add sounds has been added. So the master is called the master. If you're working as a team, the master contains the latest version of your code. So when everybody works on different branches and you want to commit your code to the master, what you do is do a pull request of your branch, and you will try to merge what you have done to the master. That is a way to control version and to prevent conflicts from happening on your code. So the next thing you want to do is compare a pull to a pull request. So once you add a comment, you add a description, and then you click on, you can check what you have done, what I have added, and you can do a create pull request on your code. Alright, so once you have done a pull request, the creator of this repository will decide that, do I want to approve your pull request, do I want to merge it to the master, or do I want to reject this? Okay, so you can, do I want to confirm the merge? Alright, okay, so it has merged to our master, and ensure that we have matched this to our master. So if we go back to our index.html, you will see here is the little comment that I added. Alright, so as newbies, these are all you need to know for now, and as it gets going tougher, you'll be learning more things about Git version control. Alright, so I'm going to stop this video here. I think I've covered enough for you to just push and pull and push your code to GitHub and what you need to know. Alright, you can just play around Git desktop. Git desktop saves a lot of lives. You can clone a repository. You can create a new repository. Once you want to clone, you clone a repository from a URL. You can clone from a URL, and you can clone. Alright, so I'm going to stop this video here. So you can please subscribe to our channel and check the descriptions for a link to our Slack channel as well. You can join, and you should follow us on Twitter as well. Alright, thank you guys. See you in the next video. Bye bye.